So Kamal Labwani has spent a lot of time in prison for his political commitment and his belief in human rights. He's also a member of the Damascene Spring and a former member of the ITILAF, the Syrian National Coalition. And we're looking forward to have his talk on the role of the Islamist brigades in the Syrian revolution and their ideology, which we talked about yesterday, and where we always also included the pictures on the wall around you that we have real grievances in Syria, we have real warfare, we have real killings of civilians that provides a very fertile narrative, unfortunately, for extremists on all sides. So please come out of the stage.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. I have to speak about Islamic movements in Syria. First of all, developing steps. In the Syrian recent history, the fail to build a modern state slipped down to dictator and corruption, which pushed the society to depend again on his traditional religious structure instead of civil society and the new government's institution systems. The exaggeration of the repression and the despair pushed the people to protest against the authority who involved more and more in violence. The Kurdish people face the security forces, military attacks, and insist in knocking down the criminal regime. The reaction of the international society was so-called. This is the army, and the people praying to avoid the army, and now there is martyrs. So, the reaction was so-called. The Syrian people get despaired of outside help, and then they return to depend on their own power to complete their revolution that gave the mosques and Islamic culture increasing role as a center of the natural traditional culture and center of the unity of the society. Also, the revolution. Islam is a center of any village. Any village, we have mosque. Mosque is the center of the society. So when any problem happened, everybody returned to traditional unity. That gives the Islam an important place for be active. So the regime exaggerated his sectarian crimes. Challenging the sects of the majority, also bringing sectarian militia from outside to fight with him. As the Islamic color gradually occupied the surface of the fighting groups, all the minorities leave the revolution and be aside of the new shape of this conflict. Lot of states help the regime in his trial to defeat his people. Trial to defeat his people because they afraid first the freedom and after that the Islam. The regime commit very terrible sectarian crimes. Very terrible sectarian crimes which invite violence and invite also volunteer to help from everywhere using Islamic ideology called jihad. Islam religion allowed to fight for defense and to help in this kind of war. Part of the fanatic Islamists group abuse this idea to continue their ideology against the virtual enemy, the West. They found a suitable time and a place to come to Syria under the propaganda of helping the victims. The despaired people may be able to welcome them if they were true. Finally, jihadist Islamic fighters find themselves leading the military action against the cruel regime, also leading the society in very hard condition, and playing an important role to keep the unity and the social peace in a free area. All of that gives them the legality and popularity. The fact that Shiite terrorist groups are also Islamists, this fact is not mentioned, and the concentration only on Sunni type. The terrorists of the regime has committed against the people more than any other kind. Imagine 200,000 killed, 200,000 disappeared, 500,000 wounded, and 10 million dislocated. Now we have to move to the ideology itself. A true Islam is the oldest shape of it. The truth, the past. Imitating the past is the aim to reach the core of Islam, the old shape as it were at the period of the Prophet Muhammad and his company represents the real Islam. Mm-hmm. So the Islamists have to wear the Islamic ancient style as a uniform masks. The underneath dress, the jungle beard, and a clipped mustache, and so. Islamic methods and laws are unnegotiable, undeveloped, and obligatory to obey. Because of that, this dogmatic ideology, able to keep the society, the social unity, and the authority of the religion. In unordinary circumstances, chaos, war, blockade, and dislocation. Maybe nothing else can do that. Islamic nation is built on the book, Quran. It is not nation as a family, as a nationality. It is nation depend on words. That's why the defense for other Muslims everywhere is a duty for everybody able to fight. So as any struggle for noble cause, the person who died called martyr, his spirits directly went to the paradise. Obeying the prince of the believers, Amir al-Mu'mineen, is a duty for every Muslim believe in the Islamic state, Islamic nation. Because of that, the Islamists are suitable for war, for wartime, and good in fighting. So society maybe need these benefits and use it to win the hard battle without outside help. Types of Islamist groups. There are a parties depend on Islamic ideology, some of them fundamental, some of them reformist, some want to develop ideology, but we concentrate on the fundamentals, which two types. The first one believes that the core of Islam inside the idea itself. And this, and the philosophy. And this is very important, and able to reread the Islam. We can reread Islam if we change the mind to read. So it is open, it is not closed. The second one we speak about, the true Islam is the best. So they are Salafists, because the best is the Islam. The Salafist also two kinds. First, non-armed groups, parties, groups living with the society. The second, armed group called Salafist jihadists, Salafiyin jihadiyin. Some of this Salafist jihadists live with the society. Some of them apart from the society or work in secret. Some of them behave against the society, and some of them then they call terrorists. When any groups live aside from society and behave against the society, we call it as a terrorist. But the American classification about the Syrian Islamist group do not separate between these kinds. Every Salafist jihadist called terrorist, whatsoever his behavior, patriot, unpatriot, against the society. So we need to renew the estimation. To define the terrorism, we have a special define using violence against the society to achieve political aims. In Islam called Khawarij, Takfiriyin. This who is a terrorist, not the jihadist, Salafist, all of them. In fact, the Islamic armed groups nowadays in Syria gathering in three main groups. First of all, Islamic Front, Al-Mujahideen Army, Islamic Ajnad al-Sham Front, يعني جبهة الإسلامية, جيش المجاهدين, and جبهة أجناد الشام الإسلامية. All of these is jihadist Salafist. Act with the society, not against the society. They are not terrorists. The second group, جبهة النصرة. Jabhat al-Nusra apart from the society, but do not act against the society. It's apart from society. It is not a state. The expiator for the prince is just to fight, not as a authority. So they are not till now, they are not behave as terrorists. Just a group for fighting, not to rule. The third group is Islamic State of Iraq and Syria. This is important. Called Daesh or ISIS. This behave as a state, as a government. And some princes, not all, some princes of it behave as a terrorist against the society. Some of princes of Daesh behave, not all, behave as a terrorist. This is victim of chemical weapons. And this is from prisons. Lot of agents of the regime and Iran and Iraqi governments work secretly in this organization. And it is now involved into conflict with all parts of FSA and Islamic groups, and do not fight the regime, just fight the Free Army. Also, it is not compatible or acceptable from any kind of society or any group of society. That's why I speak the terrorism is from outside the society, not from the inside the society of Syria. There is also non-Islamic fighters, FSA, Free Syrian Army. They are Muslim, patriot groups, but do not use the Islamic as ideology. I have to speak about the approximately numbers to imagine the balance. In opposition part, if we speak about actual fighters, we speak about 100,000 of active fighters now in Syria, fighting in Syria. 7,000 foreign fighters. Less than 2,000 come from West states. Less than 2,000 come from West states. Daesh, Dawlat al-Iraq wal-Sham, approximately 10,000 fighters. Half of them, 5,000, is foreign. Al-Nusra, also the same size, 10,000 fighters, 2,000 of them foreign. Islamic groups, about, who really fighting now, about 40,000 fighters. They are not terrorists, they are not foreign. FSA, all the groups don't use Islam, also the same, 40,000. We can speak about also 100,000 as reservists. They are not working now, but they have weapons, they're able to fight. Also, we can speak about 200,000 of people, volunteer, ready to fight if they have chance and weapons. Lot of outside volunteers will attend if the Sunni going to defeat it. Or, I don't know, the crimes continue. Or if the aims expanded to Lebanon, to Jordan, to anywhere. So it is up to the circumstances. We have to compare with the regime part. The regime part have 10,000 of Hezbollah fighters, Shia, militia, based in Lebanon, all of them foreign, outside. 10,000 from Hezbollah, 10,000 from Revolution Guards of Iran, approximately 15,000 Shia militia come from Iraq and Yemen and Iran and Afghanistan and Pakistan and Russia. 40,000 local sectarian militia, volunteer, Shabiha, and public committees, Lijan Shabi. The regime have now approximately 80,000 soldiers of the regime, half of them in Republic Guards and Special Forces, Quwat Khassa Haras Jumhuri, which pure sectarian controlled. We have to analyze the society, moderate, in the middle of the society, moderate Islam, it is usual Islam. In the condition of war, at the side of the society, near to the border of the society, we have extremists, Islamic extremists. They are approximately 10% in normal in peace and in war rise to approximately 40%. We have also, apart from the society, we have fanatic groups, but not act against the society. Some of fanatic groups outside the society or living in secret way, they work against the society, they called terrorists. Also, we have to know that the Islamic movements get more violent if they separated from the society, they face blood, the crimes and the repression, the despair and ignorance, also the secret work. All these elements rise up the violence of Islamists. I am sorry to say that the war sometimes is necessary to don't let who commit crimes to have benefits. You have to fight him to don't let him escape with his crimes. Sometimes you don't find anything else to do just to fight. And I am sorry also to say that the majority have to fight till when this war, to keep the unity and the identity and rebuild the state. Sorry to say that no chance to achieve peace without knocking down the regime and implement justice. And to win this war, we have to be strong, we have to be strict and hard. After that, we have to do a new revolution, cultural revolution, I think this period is period for war. After that, we need revolution in culture. Then we have to change the elements of, now we depend on jihadist Salafist. After that, we depend on reform. We depend on Sufi. We depend on other methods. I, as expert, I think Syria cannot jump directly from civil war to democratic. We need a transition period. We speak about, after winning the war, we speak about 10 years to make reform, to make democratic rebuild. And so, thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For showing us also pictures that oftentimes are not being shown in Western media, especially of killed children who are the main victims of this war. You may have noticed some pictures you showed us were also from the same photographer center called Exhibition here. So when you say you take about 10 years for the revolution to advance, continue, find a way of transition to a democracy with the high numbers of the sectarian, motivated and driven fighters in this conflict right now. How do you see, how can there be a way to implement or start reconciliation between the people and the different groups in your opinion? Difficult.
I have time?
You have time.
Okay, thank you. That's super. Sorry. I think Syria now is destroyed, not just the building, also the minds, also the sensation. Imagine that a child play by cut-headed. How much the danger, how much the damage, I don't know. But I can compare with Lebanon, with Iraq, I think after 3 years of this damage, or maybe continue more, I think we need time. We need time. But just of all, we have to stop. Not without justice. Without justice, we cannot rebuild the peace. Nobody can build peace in the society without justice. If we built it in a crime, we will face revenge. We have desert culture. Desert culture. Anybody can commit a crime. But he have to expect the war from the others. All of them will lose if the crimes continue. This is the message. Because the regime escaped the justice for 40 years, some of people going to revolt. Not all, I think not all. But because there is crimes and insist in committing crimes, I start my opposition activity since 1975. And work with all parts of secret parts in Syria and try everything to make reform, to stop the crimes of the regime, dictator, killing and corruption. I cannot. I failed. After that the revolution blew up. I were in a prison. I they sentenced me for 20 years. When the revolution blew up, I expect that because nobody can stand these crimes to continue forever. The father dead, the son come. Endless. That's why the despair for reform pushed the people to demonstrate. Now, the people who demonstrate is not good, is not educated, is not organized, they are not angels. They have the same culture. They have the same culture of corruption, of crimes, of torture. So we need time. But just first of all, we need to stop the crimes, stop the criminals, and say no, any criminals can escape now. That's why I say Geneva is not the good way. It's not the good way for peace in Syria. Lahai is the best way. If we go through Lahai to Geneva, that means we will build the peace in the Middle East. In this way, if we jump, who use the chemical weapons? Who killed 200 prisoners? 200,000 prisoners killed secretly in this prisons? Insisting, not it is a crime of person. And you see the pictures. So who commits these crimes? It is, you have not to discuss this matter. How? I don't know. So I think if we are going to rebuild the peace in Middle East, we have to concentrate on justice first. When we achieve justice for everything, for killing Hariri, for anything, we need justice. We need to say to everybody, you cannot commit crimes and escape. That's why we will stop violence, we will stop terrorism, we will stop everything. If we jump justice, we cannot achieve. I am against my friend Walid because he believes in Geneva. I believe in La Hague.
The Hague.
Hague. I believe in international court. And veto of Russia stopped all the tools of society, of the international society. Stop. Security Council, stop criminal courts, and stop everything and go instead of them to the high to negotiate with whom? With who has very bloody hand. It is against my principles, not because I don't looking for peace. No, because I cannot achieve peace with the criminals. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any more? We maybe have two questions, short and brief, maybe different from a different side. And are there any more questions from the audience? Otherwise, we'll continue. Maybe it's better later, because you always have a very long kind of question. Then I would... But given the time is so fast advanced, I would propose we move on to Molham Matroubi. He's the from the Syrian Muslim Brotherhood, the Executive Committee, and we will hear. Thank you, Kamal.